As of August 26th of 2024, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Italy's spectacular Mount Etna volcano, which is currently producing weak and intermittent Strombolian explosions from its Vorgine crater. Mount Etna is a 600,000-year-old stratovolcano which has been erupting at a high rate for some time, frequently showering nearby towns with light amounts of ash. Mount Etna is most famous for its sporadic paroxysms that occur between its weaker eruptions, with the term meaning a short yet violent burst of activity. These paroxysms can create dense ash emissions, kilometer-high lava fountains, pyroclastic flows, or even flank lava flows, with six such paroxysms having occurred so far during 2024. But first, keeping up with the latest scientific news like what I'm covering today is becoming challenging. It's why I cover geologic topics not widely discussed by major news outlets, and why today's extended duration video is sponsored by Ground News. Ground News makes it easier to make sense of the news, save time on researching, and keep properly informed. They do this by gathering articles from across the world into one place and providing unique context about each source. This includes a source's political leanings, ownership, and general factual reliability. I personally love Ground News for their blind spot feature, which helps to show you important news stories that you otherwise would have likely missed due to your own political leanings. Ground News can even help you identify your own biases through the My News Bias page, with this being the biases it identified for me personally based on my reading habits. I only take sponsorships from brands I trust and wouldn't recommend them if I didn't think it was relevant for my audience or if I didn't use the platform myself. Go to ground.news/geologyhub to give it a try with plans starting as low as 83 cents a month. If you sign up through my link, you'll get 40% off the Vantage plan, which is what I use for access to all their features. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Iceland, a glacial flood termed a jökulhlaup began, which originated from Iceland's Grimsvotn volcano, causing the rate of water flowing out of a major river to double within only 8 hours. Remaining in Iceland, but heading 250 kilometers to the west, the sixth volcanic eruption of Iceland's Reykjanes volcano in 9 months began, quickly causing approximately 15.29 square kilometers to be covered in a fresh layer of lava. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, a new magmatic intrusion occurred at the Kilauea volcano, resulting in a strong swarm of earthquakes. And, in what is this week's top story, there's a true danger that one of the most potentially dangerous volcanoes in Indonesia could erupt, specifically Mount Awu. My reasoning for this involves the following factors. First of all, Awu has been experiencing incredibly high levels of uplift since its latest episode of unrest began in 2021, totaling not 6.1 centimeters, but rather 6.1 meters, or a whopping 20 feet. Yikes. This places Awu as the volcano experiencing the single highest rate of uplift on the planet which is not actively erupting. This uplift largely began around June of 2023 when magma began refilling its 3-kilometer depth magma chamber. This magma chamber appears to have then become full, resulting in viscous andesite composition magma slowly rising towards the surface and reaching an estimated depth of 1 kilometer in February 2024. And now, 6 months later, magma could be as little as 500 meters under the lava dome which formed in the 2004 eruption, or even be directly right underneath it. To quickly summarize why Awu is so dangerous, I could best call it the Pele of Indonesia, with the island size and population it sits on actually being fairly comparable to the island of Martinique. Awu has produced large and destructive eruptions with long-distance pyroclastic flows and lahars which have caused fatalities about once every 70 years. Altogether, these eruptions have resulted in 12,580 deaths. What changed at Awu this week was that on August 23rd, the number of daily volcanic earthquakes spiked to around half a dozen, the visible gas emissions coming off of its 2004 lava dome almost completely ceased, and this occurred alongside repeated episodes of what is known as spasmodic tremor. While a spasmodic tremor can have multiple causes, in this case I interpret to be caused by viscous magma attempting to break through a section of blocked conduit and the dome above it, with it being blocked from material due to its 2004 eruption. If this pressure was to get high enough, the lava dome could be obliterated either partially or fully, beginning an explosive eruption that would likely send pyroclastic flows beyond its crater rim. However, the most likely outcome at the present seems to be no eruption occurring, with a double-digit chance of an eruption soon beginning being most likely in of itself to produce a moderately sized rather than major explosive eruption. So please, keep out of the existing 5-kilometer exclusion zone around Awu in all directions. Heading over to Hawaii, this week saw another magmatic intrusion occur in Kilauea's East Rift Zone, the fourth to occur since July began. In this case, the magmatic intrusion was centered 1,500 feet west of Pa'ahi Crater and generated a swarm of several hundred earthquakes between August 19th and August 20th. Activity at Kilauea has shifted primarily to its East Rift Zone since mid-July, and this has resulted in magma building underneath three distinct spots, including around the Pu'u'o'o cone, which has not erupted since 2018. The good news is that the Upper East Rift Zone where the failed magmatic intrusion occurred this week does not have any structures at risk for an eruption to occur there. Also, eruptions which do occur in this area are almost always over within 24 hours. Since 1964, the Upper East Rift Zone region has experienced 54 magmatic intrusions and only 5 of these resulted in eruptions, meaning recent magmatic intrusions have a success rate of 9.3% there. In Iceland, this week saw a new eruption of the Reykjanes volcano and in the first 5 days, what is now the peninsula's largest eruption in 700 years has quickly covered approximately 15 square kilometers in a layer of lava. Due to the lack of a quick transition from a multi-kilometer long fissure that was initially 7 kilometers in length to a singular spatter cone, it is thought that this eruption might be one for the long haul. It could still be ongoing in September or even October. However, something else occurred in Iceland this week. Specifically, an unusual glacial flood known as a Jökulhlaup that originated from the Grimsvotn volcano. At Grimsvotn, these floods can occur for 3 reasons, which I will now list from most likely to least likely. 1. A short-term increase in fumarolic degassing underneath the volcano, causing additional ice to melt and build in volume. 2. A long-term buildup in meltwater underneath the glacier due to normal levels of fumarolic degassing. Or 3. A volcanic eruption. In this case, the Jökulhlaup originated from the westernmost of the 3 cauldrons that can produce these floods, likely due to reason number 2, as it represented that cauldron's first such flood since September of 2021. Unusual earthquakes associated with the subglacial movement of meltwater began on August 17th, and by 3 days later it reached the Skaftá River, causing the water levels flowing through it to jump from 95 cubic meters per second to 175 cubic meters per second. This then flowed to the south, causing minimal flooding of uninhabited riverbanks into rivers. In the context of Jökulhlaups, this was quite small, and since it was not associated with increased volcanic activity at Grimsvotn, Grimsvotn's alert level remained at green. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 26th of 2024.